Sir Keith Bright resigned 5 months ago when the Fennel report on the King's Cross tragedy was published. The report criticised underground bosses for complacency and confusion over safety at the time of the disaster. Until now, Sir Keith, who was chairman of London Regional Transport, has been silent on that report. But in a controversial letter to the Transport Secretary Paul Channon, he's now criticised the emergency services and deeply offended the firefighters who tackled the King's Cross blaze.
It's a scandalous comment to make. I mean, nobody from the fire service had to resign. In fact, praise was heaped on him. He had to resign and he has the audacity to make this comment.
How do you think people will feel who were injured and involved in the fire?
Well, our firefighters and the widow, Mrs. Townsley, the morale must have been hit very hard today by this comment.
Sir Keith's letter suggests that in attacking underground management, the Fennel report overlooked mistakes by the emergency services. It points to evidence that the fire wasn't immediately tackled by the first transport police and firefighters on the scene. And it questions why the public was allowed to follow officers onto the station. But the letter has been widely dismissed today as insensitive.
I think it must be the sourest grapes I've ever heard, frankly. He was a man who I believe was forced to resign from his position because of the responsibility that he held. And to come at this point and criticise the emergency services when Fennel didn't do so, a very, very thorough inquiry that really said this is a management responsibility and they failed and certainly did not point the finger at the emergency services. A very sad criticism, I think, for him to be making at this time.
The fire brigade says the first officers on the scene had to assess the situation before deciding on action, and at the inquiry, an independent police advisor reported favourably on the way British Transport Police acted. Today, Sir Keith has been unavailable for comment. This is Theresa Driscoll for Thames News.